It is the creation of an organism, and
according to researchers, the aim of these sensors in dementia is to but in some cases, patients suffer more during the treatment process, may need to do a lot of chemotherapy and radiation therapy. The process of the therapy also that patients are suffering a lot. So the family and the patient need to face another such big stress. The most frequent complication is called graft versus host disease. It develops when blood cells form from the donor stem cell. Think your cells are foreign and attacked. Between 30% and 70% of the patient with a donor stem cell transplant have some form of graft versus host disease. It may be mild, serious, or even death threatening. The symptoms of graft versus host disease, such as rash, itching, hair loss, nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, and even can lead to liver damage. The chances of graft versus host disease increase when you and the donor are not closely matched. So many people in this world, the chance of the two cells match closely is very difficult, even the relatives or the patients. Having extensive chemotherapy and radiation therapy also can rise the risk. Also, people who have stem cell transplants become infertile. This is not caused by the transplantation, but rather by the high dosage of the chemo and radiation therapy. This treatment affects both normal and abnormal cells in our body, and often damage reproductive organs. Children are so important for the family members. Stem cells transplant will let them cannot be a mother or father anymore. So with support, the stem cells will be back.
Good afternoon to everyone. I'm Sheena, the second speaker for the opposition group. And as stated earlier by Yana, my first speaker, there are very reasons why we want to oppose the banning of stem cell cloning. So stem cell cloning, I'll just short form at SEC. I will now use the ethical principle of beneficiary to support opposing view. Besides the benefit of stem cell cloning, being able to treat patients with dementia, do you not understand that stem cell cloning can be treated for patients with leukemia? Leukemia is a cancer that affects the blood of the patient. In order for patients to be treated, they will have to go undergo chemotherapy or stem cell transplant. Patients who undergo chemotherapy are enduring much pain and suffering in order to get it treated. Imagine your loved ones or yourself from getting cancer and being treated with chemotherapy. It is not a pleasant situation to be in. Now, consider the fact that the patient still has to go undergo stem cell transplant. To be treated with stem cell transplant, you require required on cells donated by a donor. However, there is a high risk that of the donor cell rejection by the immune system. So this can result in terrible complications such as liver damage, hair loss, and scaly skin. Once again, understand and fix that the patient is in. Having said, to undergo chemotherapy which is filled with pain and stem cell transplant, which many not work. Thus, I appeal to the floor to realize how beneficial stem cell cloning can be for a patient suffering from leukemia. With stem cell cloning, tissues and cells can be regenerated, which will reduce the risk of patient developing a rejection to his own cells of the patient results. The patient will be able to have a pleasant and more assured chance of recovering. Beyond using stem cell cloning to treat leukemia, it can also be used to provide treatment for plastic reconstructive surgery, like those people who are having accidents or lost their limbs. So with this new technology, cloning can manufacture fats, connective tissues, cells, cartilages that matches identically with the patient's tissues. Thus, patients suffering from any deformities due to the accident will be able to be treated day by day. So even patients with loss of limbs are able to have their limbs regenerated with the help of cloning. How wonderful that would be for a patient to recover from unsightly deformities or disabilities. Thus, we oppose our stem cell cloning as it brings many more benefits for our patients whom we care for very much, and seeing them to recover is our desire.
I agree with you that destruction of human life cannot be justified, even if the aim is to save another human's life. Murdering a life for another, is that even a use? Basically, we believe that it is an unarmed ethical act. It is against the virtue of the ethical principle. That is, and non-male citizens. In simple terms, benefits is the duty to provide benefits to patients or clients, or to remove harm from them. Well, for non-male citizens, is not to do any harm. Since obtaining stars for cloning is equal to murder, which means it harm to the unborn instead of dedicated. To conclude my speech, murdering a life over another is not a debate, and it is not fair to the unborn life and hence themselves to be equal.
Well, I'm just asking because I'm seeing kill one life for another, right? What makes you think that you must kill a life just to get the stem cell? I mean, you can also get cord stem cells, which is like after the birth of a baby, you can also use the cord cells to get clone. And other cats as well. I shall relate. papers or anywhere that proven that how high is the effect of being given and the patients die of other new medical condition introduced to them?
But we don't have a successful examples.
Successful stories are only
the human
harvesting from a cloned human embryo. It provided a necessary breakthrough to research on neuromuscular disease, which can affect people of all ages. Thus, the ethical concern of stem cell is overshadowed by the good it brings about when it can help to prevent genetic diseases. As a result, mankind can be benefited by the use of stem cell cloning. Once again, I reinforce that stem cell cloning brings about much good to the society. This is because it is able to treat and prevent diseases and infirmities. Thus, not banning stem cell cloning can grant men the chance to live healthily and pursue their ambitions and desires. Surely, that is a quality of life that we have learned about in MHNC. Thus, I beg you to stand by us for the goodness of stem cell cloning. Thank you.
Atika, just now you have stated, right, you and your team, right, that everyone can provide receive the treatment and they will recover, right? Everyone is doing it, so they may have different reaction for this treatment. So no one can actually predict or provide 100% reassurance that he will be a successful treatment for everyone. How sure are you? 100%? No, right? Anyway, I'm seeing the last speaker for my proposition team. As mentioned by the previous speaker, Wishan, there will be another problem arise due to this stem cell cloning, which is increase in population. Yes, indeed, embryonic stem cell cloning can be treatment to many kind of health conditions as stated by the opposition team. However, by doing so, lifespan of the people will be increased for many years, thus there will be increase in percentage of aging population. Each embryonic stem cell is a life form which eventually becomes a humankind, but by cloning the stem cell, which means killing a life, which stated by Yang Hui earlier on, murder, there will be no new generation be created. Aging population increase, this will affect economics of the country, as majority of the population will be consist of the elderly or older adults who may not be able to contribute effectively and efficiently to the society as compared to the younger ones. After all, elderly and the older adults are the ones who are seeking the treatment, not us. Also, for every embryonic stem cell cloning that is cloned, an unborn infant is killed to save the life of an older adult. No new generation created, like I said earlier. This will result in small and still talent pool. Unborn infants could have someone who can create a new invention or produce new ideas that can benefit the humankind or even any countries in the whole world. According to the ethical principle autonomy, it has three components like the learning class. Individual's right to choose informed decision, whereby the information are given by the medical personnel, competency and capacity. With the use of stem cell cloning to prolong the life of an elderly, it's a breach of the component competency, which means the ability to perform a task or job effectively. Apply this to Singapore setting. Singapore government has been always wanting to recruit many types of foreign talent to Singapore to increase the talent pool in Singapore. However, with this stem cell cloning technology, talent pool everywhere will decrease. Singapore will then not be able to find any more talent to help Singapore flourish. As we know, Singapore is already considered as an aging populated country. And with the aid of this stem cell cloning, aging population will increase again and again. Singapore is a very small country. Thus, when the aging population increases, this means that the economic progress will slow down significantly. Like Xiang Lu said earlier, all in all, success rate of this stem cell cloning is very low, and because it gives a false hope to one receiving treatment, and the chance of compatibility is not guaranteed. If let's say you are given this treatment and the doctor cannot guarantee that you will be recovered 100%, will you want to fork out this amount to receive this treatment? I doubt so. It's really a waste of money. A condition may be deteriorate or even result him or her with many other problems associated with his health, as said earlier by Kang Chao. Also, it's very risky to take embryonic stem cell as compared to the other as they have little life force. Moreover, by extracting the embryonic stem cell, the growth of the embryo will be Debate1. Even though it's for the good for the people, this is the courage by taking a life from an unborn child to treat several animals. We are not gods. We are people. Eventually, die. It's the life of a cycle. And you will be, will you be guilt-free even though innocent, when innocent emotions fights for your own benefit?
Thank you.
Let's
give up.
Terminally ill. You want them to continue.